Hi guys, welcome back to Digital Lab. We've taken apart lots of different power adapters from Apple, but there are all new products released in recent years. Today, let's go back to 2006 and see what kind of power adapter Apple released that year. This is an original 110 watts power adapter for Mac Mini from early 2006 to late 2009. The power supply was not integrated inside the Mac Mini at that time. Just like most gaming laptops, it was independent outside the device. The white plastic shell slightly turned yellow, the input prongs are grounded. And all specs info are printed here, modulus A1188. It supports input of 120V, 50/60Hz, 2.5A, and the output can be up to 18.5V, 6A, 110W. Like traditional power adapters, the input power cord can be detachable, and the output connector looks like USB-C, but, you know, there was no USB-C connector back then. The length of the input power cord is about 1.8 meters. The size of this power adapter is about 164.5 by 64.5 by 35 mm. And the output cable is about 1.7 meters. The total length exceeds 3.5 meters. And the total weight is about 730 grams. Since we do not have an old Mac Mini to test, we'll take it apart directly to see what differences are inside compared to recent Apple power adapters. The white plastic case can be easily removed, but the internal metal cover is definitely Apple's traditional design. It's fixed with screws and soldered to the PCB. After removing the metal heatsink, a layer of mylar sheet is under it. The red, black, and blue wires are connected to the input end of the PCB. Let's take a close look. Unlike the Apple chargers we've taken apart, it has a brown PCB instead of a black one. Those components are relatively sparse, and the back of the PCB is green. We found it adopts flyback topology and has a PFC circuit. The Schottky diode inside can rectify the current, and the output voltage can be regulated through the optocoupler. Let's start from the input end to introduce those old components. The input fuse is from Littelfuse, 4A, 250 volts. The common mode choke is fixed next to the fuse and is insulated with heat shrinkable tubing. The safety X2 capacitor is from Carli, with a capacity of 0.68 microfarad. The second common mode choke is larger than the first one, and is not insulated with heat shrinkable tubing. A dark green varistor is used for overvoltage protection. The bridge rectifier is used to rectify the AC into pulsed DC for the PFC circuit. The film capacitor is from Carli, 0.47 microfarad. Another red film capacitor is used for filtering. The toroidal coin inductor is between two film capacitors used for output filtering. The PFC controller is from Infineon, which works in DCM mode. It supports output voltage and under voltage protection. The primary MOSFET is from Infineon and adopts TO220FP package, 650 volts, 385 milliohm. The PFC boost inductor is tightly wound and insulated with yellow tape. Two fast recovery diodes are used for PFC rectification, and the magnetic ferrite can suppress high frequency interference. This electrolytic capacitor is from Rubycon KXW series, 420 volts, 150 microfarad. The mass control chip is from ON Semiconductor, is a high-performance PWM controller with low standby power consumption. It integrates high-voltage start, PFC control, soft start, and various protection functions. The other primary MOSFET is also from Infineon, but in a different model. It adopts a TO220FP package, 650 volts, 380 milliohm. Those two resistors are placed between two MOSFETs and used to detect the current of MOSFETs. two capacitors power the mass control chip. The larger one is 35 volts, 47 microfarad, and the smaller one is 25 volts, 47 microfarad. This is the diode for RCD snubber circuit, and the resistor for RCD snubber circuit. Here is the ceramic capacitor with a withstand voltage of 1 kV. The largest component is the transformer. Two optocouplers next to the transformer used to regulate the output voltage. Those three Schottky diodes are front diodes and adopt TO220 package. They are connected in parallel for rectification. Withstand voltage is 150 volts and the current is 20 amp. The blue ceramic capacitor is connected in series with a resistor to absorb peak voltage. Those two electrolytic capacitors for output filtering are from Rubycon ZLH series, 25 volts, 1500 microfarad for each. Flip to the back, the dual operational amplifier is from STMicroelectronics, used for output voltage feedback and constant current control. The output current sense resistor is 5 mA. Well, that's all components of this Apple power adapter released nearly 20 years ago. It's much like the big and heavy power adapters we've seen on some Windows gaming laptops, but now the power supply has been integrated into the Mac Mini. After taking it apart, we found that the internal heat dissipation and protection measures are similar to the current Apple power adapter, which makes this charger high quality. But the internal module design is not very compact, and the topology is relatively outdated. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!